A group of Gulf Coast fishermen, oystermen, and shrimpers have filed a class action lawsuit against oil giant BP and the owners of the rig that exploded in the Gulf of Mexico. The suit is the first of its kind to be filed by those whose livelihood will be directly impacted by the BP oil spill. Joining us now is Mike Papantonio, whose firm has filed that first suit. Can you tell me, if you could, sir, how soon you think that there might be some financial relief? I mean, after all, these oystermen, these shrimpers, these fishermen, they're going to be hurting in a few days.
That's the problem. Here it is. If BP and Halliburton and and all the defendants want to do what they say they want to do, and that's to get these people immediate relief, they have the way to do it. There's a fund. It's called the Oil Spill Liability Trust Fund. But the problem, Brian, is they always try to put all types of hoops that you have to jump through to get that money. Right now, we have commercial fishermen who can't fish, shrimpers, oysters, resort owners, dive businesses, seafood distributors. If they really want to do what they're saying, it's almost as if they want to sing kumbaya with all these people. Don't sing kumbaya. Give these people money. They can't make their house payments. They can't put food on the table. This isn't imaginary. We get these calls every day with people who have been in the business of things. Something as simple as a rental property owner who's counting on the summer season saying, look, I've had 50% cancellations. If BP and these people really want to do the decent thing, don't send us your defense lawyers from New York and L.A., send us the money that you know you can give these people immediately. Don't put strings attached to it. They have all kinds of ways to help these people, Brian.
Let me jump in because I have a couple of questions that I think are sort of really important to this whole issue. Number one, BP, everybody says, is responsible. But if you listen very carefully to what the officials at BP have said, they have sort of suggested from time to time, well, it really was the rig operator's responsibility to make sure that all the safety rules were followed. Are they going to try to shove this all off on the rig operator, which they hired?
Brian, you're going to see him pointing fingers at everybody. Look, this isn't BP's first rodeo. They have a checkered safety record that we have to talk about. The media is not talking about this, Brian. I hope I can talk to you about it.
Go ahead.
It's like having a white elephant in the living room. And here it is. In 2005, they had one of the worst safety failures in a refinery in America. 15 people killed, 170 people injured. And you know what? They had to plead guilty to felony charges. Prudhoe Bay, Alaska, 6,000 barrels of oil purely spilled because of safety cost cutting. They had to admit that in the end. They were fined. These stories are just the edge. Let's be clear about something. They have no disaster response plan. They had no planning. And just like your reporter just told you, it's absolutely true. The Mineral and Management Department was told by this company that said, look, it's not a problem. And you know what? The other part of the story is, Brian, part of the story is mineral management has become a lapdog for companies like BP. That's part of the problem here.
All right, we're going to leave it right there. I think we have heard your point loud and clear. Thank you for joining us. It's good to have you. And let me just point out, I want to read a quote, if I could, from BP to be fair and balanced. There should be no doubt of our resolve to limit the escape of oil and protect the marine and coastal environments from its effects. That comes from Tony Hayward, the BP Group Chief Executive.